The Electoral Commission has commenced the demarcation of electoral areas for the 2025-2026 local government's council elections. This is a critical process that aims to define the areas of representation for the directly elected councillors, women councillors, councillors representing special interest groups. In a keynote address at the National Stakeholders Workshop on Demarcation of Electoral Areas and Recognizing of the Polling Stations, Justice Byabakama Mugenyi Simon, the chairperson of the Electoral Commission, emphasized the importance of the demarcation exercise.
That for you to vote at the polling station, the critical record is the National Voters Registration. At that polling station, whether you have your ID or not, you are allowed, you are free woman customer. That's what we introduced the biometric system.
The EC also announced plans to recognize the polling stations across the country, a move aimed at ensuring that each parish and electoral area has at least one polling station. The demarcation and reorganization exercise will consider means of communication, geographical features, and the density of population. The EC has called on stakeholders to support the exercise, emphasizing that a credible election process is a multi-stakeholder responsibility. The demarcation exercise, which was initially scheduled for August 2023, has been delayed due to funding constraints. However, the EC assured stakeholders that the process will be completed in August 2024.
We have said the best way forward to address the legal challenges in this country is to have a dialogue, have a conversation about it. And we believe even when it comes to the issue and the actual security, the best way is to have a conversation with them plus other stakeholders, because we need security. We also have a role to play.
The Minister for Justice and Constitutional Affairs and the President of the Democratic Party, Norbert Mao, has unveiled plans to recruit new members. This was revealed at the press conference at the DP Party Head Office at Balintume Road in Kampala. Mao also expressed his intention to contest for presidency for the Democratic Party and later contest for the presidency in the 2026 general elections.
Nafe tugenda kwesi mbao. Mtu yena ajerega DP nze musasira nyo.
As Minister for Justice and Constitutional Affairs, Mao said that he intends to meet all the political parties to discuss plans to reduce the number of legislators in Parliament.
Proportional representation.
The DP president also revealed that the party intends to open over 15 party offices around the country, is mobilization and strengthen the party structures at the grassroots. The Nakawa Chief Magistrate Court has today granted bail to four more youths accused of participating in last week's anti-corruption march to Parliament.
At Oasis Mall on Nakumat in the Kampala district, did an act of gathering together while shouting, "Anita must resign." Visor Salima, have you understood?
Yes, I have.
Is it true or not?
It's not true.
Chief Magistrate Rita Kidasaniumbe released the group pending a hearing of the case scheduled at a later date. Those granted bail include 20-year-old NTV Uganda and KFM radio host Faiza Salima, Thomas Kanzira, 28, Bernard Olupot, Ewalu, 39, and 25-year-old Edgar Balo Hamala. The court declined to release 40-year-old Ajab Musinguzi because of the introduction letter presented from the local council indicating a different area of residence.
That the prosecution be given adequate time to have the same documents verified.
Since the learned state attorney has not informed this honorable court when these investigations will be concluded, it is open to uncertainty.
The trial chief magistrate also dropped the charges of idle and disorderly, leaving the suspect with only one charge of common nuisance. This was after the prosecution led by Doreen Elima presented an amended charge sheet indicating that it was an instruction from the Director of Public Prosecutions to have the charge sheet amended. According to the charge sheet, Kanzira, Salima, Olupot, Hamala, Musinguzi and others still at large on the 23rd of July at Oasis Mall Nakumati in Kampala district gathered while shouting "Anita must resign," thereby causing annoyance, obstruction or inconvenience to the public.
I shall then go on to consider each individual application.